I already made a guide on Vita 3K and it absolutely blew up and currently is the most popular video on my channel. So some stuff has changed and in this video I'm going to cover everything for the setup to get the emulator working. So there are three things you need. First of all, of course, you need Vita 3K, the actual emulator. You need the PS Vita update software. And you also need the ROMs, of course, so keep that in mind. So how to get the emulator? Go to vita3k.org and here you can go right to download. Right here, pick whatever build you need. I'm going to show how to use it on Windows, so I'm going to use that. So grab from AppFayer. Once you're over here, just click the latest build. It should be right here. Download this wherever you want. For me, it is an emulator and PS Vita, but it is up to you where you want to keep it. So just make something which is organized for you. So while this is downloading, let's head over to the PlayStation site to download the latest PlayStation Vita firmware. This is also linked in the emulator itself, but I'm going to drop the link in the description below so you can find it very easily. So right here, click agree and download now. Again, download this wherever you want, it doesn't really matter since you will be installing it later on. So click save and it will download. Keep in mind this can take a few seconds because it's quite a large file. So now let's show it in the folder. And right here we got the latest Vita 3K master. If you can't extract this, just download WinRAR or 7-zip, both work. And then right click it and extract it to a folder. That is really recommended for me. And then you get these folders. Right here you can see vita3k.exe. Make sure to double click it and open it up. It will take a second and then you will be greeted with this screen. Right now go to file and here click install firmware. Now go to the files we just downloaded, so in PS Vita and the PS Vita update.pub. Click this, click open and it will install for you. While it is installing, Vita 3K may see as not responding. Don't worry, it is just installing and the program doesn't respond while it's doing it. So just be patient and wait until it's done. Once it is done, it will say firmware installation and it is successfully installed. And right here, it will show the firmware version. You can also delete the installation file, so the .pub, if you want, so that can save some space. You can check it right here, it doesn't matter. If you want to keep it, make sure it is unchecked. If you want to delete it, just check it and press OK. So now let's actually install a game. For this, click File and then here click Install Game and go to wherever you got your ROMs. So for me, it is in this folder. And there are two ways to install it. First of all, you can install the .vpk and make sure this is dumped via my dumper. Otherwise, it won't work in the emulator, so vitamin dumps don't work, so keep that in mind. So then simply double click it or click it and click open. And it should install and it takes a while and then installs and then you're good to go. So right here, it shows the game. And there also is another way of installing games. For this again, go to install game. And if you got a decrypted dump right here, for Persona 4 Golden for example, you can just zip all the contents of this folder and the zip also is installable. So if you click the zip and click open, it will open up and install just like the .vpk style. And this also works, so keep in mind both things are usable. So simply click open and it will take a second to install. Right here you can see successfully installed the game Persona 4 Golden and then version 1.0. And again, you can select to delete the package or don't. I'm going to keep it for if I ever want to reinstall Vita 3K. And then you got these two games. So first of all, if you right click the game, you can here click boot. You can copy the game info if you want. You can open the folder and you can delete the game and delete the shader log. And here's some general information. Opening the folder and then clicking game can be very useful if you want to see where the game is installed. So right here the game is installed in Vita 3K and then UX0 app and then the game right here. And before we are going to start the game, let's head over to configuration and here you can click settings. And here are some really basic settings. So here you can enable or disable some core things. Don't really recommend changing any of this unless you know what you're doing. For the GPU, again, don't change any of this unless you know what you're doing. And this actually is for pretty much everything in the system. Here you can change the console language if you want, so that can be really useful. Also the enter button can be configured right here. For the emulator right here, you can select what log level you want, so trace, debug, errors. Again, doesn't really matter unless you're troubleshooting something. Right here in the GUI, you can here make it visible when playing games. And here just do whatever you want and increase the icon size, doesn't really matter again. And for the debug, don't touch this. If you are a developer, you probably already know how to do this stuff. So now let's actually boot into a game. Simply double click it and then press start and it should load up. So right now this is actually a game which doesn't display any graphics, so you won't see anything, but you can hear the music. And one thing I do want to mention, there is a Persona 4 Golden build. So if you want to try Persona 4 Golden, which is probably the most anticipated game for this emulator, you can use this build. I will leave it in the pinned comment below, so make sure to check it out. And if there's something in development happening to Persona 4 Golden, I will leave it there again. So right now I'm going to close this window and open up the folder where we got the PS4 update stuff. And right here I got the Persona 4 Golden build. So again, this will be linked in the pinned comment. So once you open up Vita 3K, and by the way, if you're going to download this, make sure to delete the config.yml right here if you got any issues. This could cause some issues. So double click it and it will open up in just a second. And right here you can see Persona 4 Golden. If you double click it, it will run and the graphics aren't perfect and the performance isn't the best, but it is working and that's already a great feat and it's really fun to just mess around with it. So I hope you saw this game does actually work and I really hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you got any questions or something isn't working, make sure to ask in the comments below or simply ask in the Discord or my Twitter or Facebook. I'm available pretty much anywhere. So if you got any issues, just let me know and I will try to help you. So again, I hope you enjoyed it and it was useful. And I'll see you in another video.